This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to do drug calculations when you have to consider the weight of the patient. So let's start with a fairly simple one, and we'll work our way up to through harder and harder ones. This says the order is for 2 milligrams per kilogram of weight, and the patient weighs 20 kilograms. We want to know how many milligrams are to be given. So as we usually do, we'll start out with the order. That's going to be a fraction, 2 milligrams over 1 kilogram. And let's fill in the unit we want to end up with. So we'll put in an equal sign, leave a place for the answer, and write down the milligrams, since that's what we need to end up with. And then what we're going to do is multiply the order amount by the patient's weight. So that's going to be 20 kilograms, and we'll just put that over 1 so we can keep everything as a fraction. And then we'll cancel out whatever units we can. Well, we can cancel out the kilograms. We're left with milligrams, which is fine. That's what we want. We've got only 1s in the denominator, so we can just multiply across to get the answer. That's 2 milligrams times 20 is 40 milligrams. Okay? So the basic approach is going to be take your order, multiply it by the patient's weight, and that will give you your answer. Okay, let's make it a little more complicated. This one, once again, says the order reads 2 milligrams per kilogram of weight. The patient, once again, weighs 20 kilograms. But now we see that the label reads 160 milligrams per 1,000 milliliters. We want to know how many milliliters are to be given. So let's start with that order. That's 2 milligrams over 1 kilogram. Let's fill in the units we want to end up with. So I'll put an equal sign, a place for the answer, and the units, milliliters. We'll multiply the order by the patient's weight. The patient weighed 20 kilograms, so that's 20 kilograms over 1. And now we've got the information for what's on hand. That's 160 milligrams per 1,000 milliliters. I want to end up with milliliters in my answer, so I'm going to take that and write it as a fraction with the milliliters in the numerator, 1,000 milliliters, over 160 milligrams. Now let's cancel out whatever units we can. Well, we've got milligrams over here and milligrams in the denominator, so they'll cancel. We've got kilograms in the numerator and kilograms in the denominator. I'm sorry, kilograms in the denominator, kilograms in the numerator, they'll cancel. I've got, let's see if we can simplify some fractions. I've got a 2 in the numerator and 160 in the denominator. So let's divide both of those by 2. 160 divided by 2 is 80. I've got 20 in the numerator and 80 in the denominator. We can divide both of those by 20. So the 80 divided by 20 will just become 4. And now what we have, let's multiply across and see. I've got 1 times 1 times 1,000 milliliters. So that's 1,000, the milliliters is written in. And for the denominators, I've got 1 times 1 times 4. So that's 1,000 over 4 milliliters. And that fraction will simplify down to 250 milliliters. Okay, so for this one, we multiplied the order by the patient's weight by the on-hand information, and that gave us our answer. Okay, let's get a little more complicated. This says the order reads 4 milligrams per kilogram of weight. The patient weighs 20 kilograms. The label reads 2 grams per 1,000 milliliters. We want to know how many milliliters are to be given. So let's write in the order. That's 4 milligrams over 1 kilogram. Let's put in the information we need to tell us what we want to end up with. We want to end up with milliliters. So I'll have that equal sign, the space for the answer, and milliliters. We'll take the order and multiply it by the patient's weight. The patient, once again, weighs 20 kilograms. So that will be 20 kilograms over 1. We've got this information for what we have on hand. The label reads 2 grams per 1,000 milliliters. And since we want milliliters in our answer, I'll put the 1,000 milliliters in the numerator, and the denominator will be the 2 grams. And then the only thing left to do is to deal with the fact that we've got milligrams in the order and grams in the on hand. So we'll use the conversion that we have. 1 gram, I'll put that in the numerator, equals 1,000 milligrams. So this should allow me to cancel out all of the units except for the milliliters. Let's see. I've got milligrams over here and milligrams over here, so they'll cancel. I've got kilograms and kilograms, so they'll cancel. And I've got grams and grams, so they cancel. I can also get rid of the thousands that I have, since I have 1,000 in the numerator, divide that by 1,000, and 1,000 in the denominator, divide that by 1,000. Let's keep simplifying. I've got a 4 here in the numerator and a 2 in the denominator, so I'll divide both of those by 2. So it's going to be 4 divided by 2 is 2, and 2 divided by 2 is just 1. At this point, I've got only 1s in the denominator, so all we have to do is multiply across the numerators to get the answer. That's 2 times 20 is 40, times 1 milliliter is 40 milliliters, times 1 is still 40 milliliters. So the answer here is going to be 40 milliliters. We got it by multiplying the order by the patient's weight by the on-hand information, by the conversion we needed because we had both grams and milligrams. Okay? And here's the last one. This one says that the order reads 4 milligrams per kilogram of weight. The patient now weighs 66 pounds. The label reads 2 grams per 1,000 milliliters. How many milliliters are to be given? Okay. So we'll start out with the order. That's 4 milligrams per kilogram. We want the answer to be in milliliters. We'll take the order, multiply it by the patient's weight. That was given in pounds. So that's 66 pounds over 1. The label reads 2 grams per 1,000 milliliters. So we'll take that information and make a fraction with the 1,000 milliliters in the numerator and the 2 grams in the denominator. Now, there's 2 more things we have to do. We've got milligrams and grams, so let's put in the conversion for that. 1 gram is the same as 1,000 milligrams, so I'll put in the fraction 1 gram over 1,000 milligrams. And I've got to deal with that 66 pounds. Well, 1 kilogram is 2.2 pounds, so I'll add one more fraction. I'll have 1 kilogram as the numerator and 2.2 pounds as the denominator. And this is all going to clear up very nicely. Let's start getting rid of the units. I've got milligrams in the numerator, milligrams in the denominator, so they'll cancel. I've got kilograms as a denominator and kilograms as a numerator, so they'll cancel. I can cancel out the pounds that I've got, and I can cancel out the grams. The only unit I'm left with is milliliters. That's how I want things to end up. I've also got 1,000 in the numerator and 1,000 in the denominator, so let's divide both of those by 1,000. I've got 4 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator. Let's divide both of those by 2. So the 4 will become a 2. The 2 just becomes a 1. I've got this 2 in the numerator and 2.2 in the denominator. I can divide both of those by 2. So the 2.2 divided by 2 is 1.1. And at this point, let's multiply across. I've got 1 times 66 times 1 times 1 times kilograms, so that's 66, milliliters. So that's 66 milliliters over 1.1. And I can simplify this fraction and turn it into just 60 milliliters. Okay, so for as complicated as this seemed, it was just a series of little steps. We wrote down the order, multiplied it by the patient's weight, multiplied it by a fraction that we got from the on-hand information, and then did whatever conversions we needed. We had to convert between grams and milligrams and between kilograms and pounds. We cleaned up everything we could, and we ended up with our answer, 60 milliliters. Okay, so I hope this all helped. Take care. I'll see you next time.